Hey everybody, welcome to What the Flick. I'm Matt, that's Alonso. Since it's Monday, we're gonna talk about new home video releases.
Yes.
Not just DVDs.
Yes, but well.
Stuff you can watch.
What, like that's one or the other?
Yeah, maybe.
Well, mine is physical media, and I don't know if you've given up on physical media, then I don't know what to tell you. But Olive Films is putting out a package of, these are all sold separately, but five titles of interesting, I guess, well, let's call them late 20th century Spanish cinema. If you don't know, my parents were both born in Spain. That's why I have all these vowels in my name. And so I try and keep up with this stuff. It's not just Pedro Almodovar. There are other dudes out there doing stuff. So all five of these films are coming out on Blu-ray in the US for the first time, including Fernando Trueba's Academy Award winning best foreign film, Belle Époque, three films from Julio Medem, Tierra, Vacas and the Red Squirrel, and the one I'm most excited about, Bigas Luna's hilarious Jamón Jamón, which features a very young and very sexy Penelope Cruz and a very young and very sexy Javier Bardem. Before they got married and before they won Oscars and before they became like the biggest deals in Spanish cinema. But it's an odd film, but it's funny and it's sexy and it's occasionally weirdly violent, but I like it a lot. I don't know if you have to have a weirdly Iberian sense of humor to get it, but I don't think so, because it actually was kind of a hit here. They play sort of star-crossed lovers from different sides of the track, and he's also in contention for becoming an underwear model. So there's a lot of women looking at his batch a lot. But hey, you know, that's Javier Bardem was. That's why he's in cinema. I don't know. There's a lot going on in this movie. It's very funny and very cool. And if you've never seen Jamón Jamón or these other films, they're all coming out this week, like I said, for the first time on Blu-ray from Olive Films.
My movie this week is Professor Marston and the Wonder Woman.
Yay!
I loved this movie. This is a movie about the creator or creators of Wonder Woman. Dr. William Moulton Marston, played by Luke Evans, and his wife, Elizabeth, who prior to starting a comic book character had basically invented the lie detector.
Correct.
Which this movie covers. And then they end up in a relationship with a young woman named Olive Byrne, who's taking class from Dr. Marston. And he is inspired by his relationship with the two of them to create this character to teach children about the power of love. And this movie
is the strength of women.
And is the strength of women. And I found this movie to be fascinating. It's based on the book by Jill Lepore, The Secret History of Wonder Woman. And this is terrific. Great performances all around, directed by Angela Robinson, who, among other things, directed Herbie Fully Loaded.
Damn right.
Which, not a bad movie.
And Debs.
Which was a bonkers movie.
I love Debs. Rebecca Hall plays Elizabeth Marston. Bella Heathcote is Olive Byrne. Yeah, this is a smart movie about, it is not your sort of usual kind of historical period biopic. It is sexy and it is smart and apparently takes great liberties with the actual facts, but that's what biopics tend to do. Right. Anyway, I think as a sort of fantasy of kind of sexual progressivism and liberation in the mid 20th century. This is a really great movie. I love the performances. I'm a fan of Angela's from way back. Very excited to see her get to do this kind of movie.
Yeah, I like this a lot. There's a couple places it's maybe a little on the nose with the inspiration about some of the elements that go into creating Wonder Woman, you know, things about the tiara the costume. But apart from that, this is a terrific movie. And if you haven't watched it, if you liked Wonder Woman and you liked, and you want more of that and were disappointed by Justice League, this is a fantastic movie because I think it actually goes with the Wonder Woman film very, very well. They a nice double feature.
It's a cool companion piece. And you know, there has been quite a bit of discussion since the Oscar nominations about, you know, Mudbound, for some people excited in the categories that it's in, other people disappointed they didn't get more. But that's from Dee Reese, who is a black lesbian filmmaker, and so is Angela Robinson. And you know, it's great to see more diverse voices represented behind the camera, and also that those voices can make different kinds of movies.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, Mudbound is about race, but it's also this sort of sprawling kind of David Lean-esque epic, you know, that spans, you know, they go to World War II and they're, you know, the Depression and all this stuff. And this is a movie that really kind of captures sort of 1940s academia and kind of a sexual underground. And, you know, I think we're seeing that, you know, creatives have lots of different stories to tell in lots of different ways. And, you know, it's exciting to get more of those voices getting to tell them.
Yeah, so your choices and this one available now, or available as of Tuesday.
I was going to say, on sale tomorrow, January 30th.
Definitely check them out.